Morning watchers, Scott from SE Landscaping. I am going out with the Grillo FD450 today on a job, and I've got a bit of an early start this morning. It's Friday, I don't intend to work the weekend, so I've left the house. Well, by the time I've got loaded up, it's 20 past five at the moment, and it's the first time I've noticed that things are starting to get dark. Mornings and nights are pulling in again. We sort of downhill till Christmas. So job today is, we've looked after a cemetery for about 10 years and it's always been great, never been an issue. And the last year the council members have changed, so from time to time you get different members come on, and a couple of them decided they would like to collect them. Bearing in mind this cemetery is around 10,000 square metres. So it's not a cheap job. Basically, from what we were originally getting, it's now increased the price four times roughly. So we could, well, I can get the majority of it with the FD450. The smaller, narrower strips we just cut with a still walk behind. But like I said, it's increased the price drastically. They are a cash rich council, so it's not as if the short of a bob or two, so it's not too bad from that point of view. But they asked us, and I think this is the third time we've boxed it off, collected it now, but we're collecting it on a weekly basis. So what we did the first time is we used to cut it with the Toro mid-size and leave the grass on the surface. So for easiness, what we did was we cut the last time we had to do it before we boxed it off, I still cut it with a Toro mid-size, and then I collected the dead grass on the Monday of the start of the following week. So we cut it on the Friday with the Toro, and then I put this machine on the Monday to pick the dead grass up and tidy it up, and that was classed as the first cut, and the guy streamed round, and then we've done two cuts since, and I'm going back again this morning just to cut the big areas, and then the guys will come in around 10 o'clock and they will cut the small areas and screw around to finish the site off. That's the plan, because I've got other jobs to go to afterwards. Got a couple of jobs to shoot off to. So I'm out early this morning, like I say, just if I didn't get out early, I would either be out till 7 o'clock tonight or I would be in on Saturday morning. And I have plans for the weekend, so it's this is the other option, which I'm up anyway. I don't mind coming out early because I'm already up early every day. Even when I'm off work, I'm still up at stupid o'clock. So, like I say, once I get to the site, we shall get you some footage of this machine. I've had it now a couple of seasons, I think, but it's actually only got about 45 hours on. So we're probably going to double that this year by the time we finish with cutting this. I bought it, and to be fair, I only do, I think, two sites with it, but those two sites, if we were cutting with the small machine, we would be on for hours, and it's very monotonous because they're big areas, so where you can shoot around this in sort of an hour on them. So that's the reason I have it. It's a high tip, so it'll lift on the van. If you had somewhere on a site, it'll lift over fences, or it'll lift into a skip, or on a trailer or something. If you're working on a farm, it's handy. It's got a decent lift point. So I shall get you some footage once we get to the job and show you what the task in hand is, and just give you an idea how big the area is, and then I'll get you a little bit of footage once we cut. Stay tuned, guys. So this is what I meant by a large cut and collect. Those are the large areas to do. And this is the top area of the site. Just big plain flat areas. These aren't too bad to do.
This is a modern world. This is the modern world. What kind of food do you think I- voices. Hey, we don't need no one to tell us what's right or wrong. This is a modern world. This is a modern world.
So that's the two large areas done. There's a couple areas in the middle there which are locked with graves, so we can't really do it. They just get trimmed with the strimmer. But if you look, and the other side, so same again, just a man to shoot round now with the trimmer up the rows. And onto the larger areas. All nice and neat. And the same over there. So that's the finished job. We've just got another one of my team is coming in a little bit just to cut the smaller areas and to strim round to finish that site off for this week. But I know a lot of you guys, you cut areas like that with small walk behinds every day. Hats off to you, to be honest, because I've seen some of the big areas people cut, and you could be, well, if you're in there, you could be in there a day and a half. But you can see the areas there, you can see how big they were and how much time those machines save. It is now 8:30, so I was on site around 5:45. So if you said 3 hours it's took there, if we were cutting that with a walk behind with a walk behind small mower and boxing it off, like I say, you would have been 9-10 hours easy, day and a half. So this machine is ideal. It's small, you can see how it copes around headstones and things. It gets into 90% of the tight areas and does a really good job. It for what the machine cost, and yes like I said earlier, it hasn't got many hours on, but it is going to pay for itself on this job alone for the rest of the summer, because they want this cut weekly, and we're getting well paid for this, so it will pay for itself. So these machines, sometimes people think, why Scott bought that machine there? Is he mad? He spent all that money. But the time came and we needed the machine. And the thing is, with machines at the moment, everything's in short supply. If I went to buy one of these, you could be waiting 6 months for one. So I've gone there a few weeks ago. I've said, yes, I can do the job. If I didn't have one of these machines and I had to go out and buy one, and I was waiting months and months for it, we would have been out with the small stills and things. So it sometimes, it swings and roundabouts. Sometimes it benefits you having machines sat for certain jobs. So, and that's how this one's worked out. Like I say, apart from this, it only does two sites, so it's not gonna, still not going to get a huge amount of hours on. I think by the end of this year with this job now, it'll probably have 130, 140 hours on by when October comes. So that's pretty much it. Any questions on these? Any questions on these machines? The Grillos. You know, everybody knows I'm a big fan of the Grillos. I've got just about every different type of Grillo, and they are great machines. Very little trouble, a couple of teeth and problems with one machine, but apart from that, it was sorted out and I've had no other issues. So really pleased. The machines are cheap. Well, they're cheap to me compared to other things. They're cheaper than the rivals, but they're actually, the build quality's no different, and like I say, the machines do what they're supposed to do. So it's a one of those where people sometimes think, oh, I need to buy this expensive machine, and you don't always need to. Sometimes it's worth getting a demo and trying something and realizing that, look, I've just saved £4,000 there and it's still doing the same job as that other one I've had on demo. So do I really need that one, or can I go with this? So like I say, that's a bit of a bit advertising for Grillo. They do demonstrations as well, so anybody think of a Grillo, especially in England anyway, I don't know about the rest of the world, but anybody in England, I know there's a couple of guys on the sites, John Condren is one of them. He is regularly pushing these machines for demos, and he will bring you the machines out and you can spend some time with them and stuff like that. So it's well worth doing. If you think of one, get on the phone to him. Or I can pass you his details, or I can pass you other people's details who will also come out and deliver you a Grillo and give you a demonstration. And apart from that, that's pretty much it. On to the next job now, going to unload and load up with another machine, which is another Grillo, incidentally, just to cut a couple of rough areas on a new job. And we will see you on the next video. Thanks for watching, guys.